Want to give your boring Linux terminal a stunning makeover? Something that makes other people go wow? All those beautiful Linux terminals you see in the screenshots posted in Linux subreddits and communities, you can get them too. I'm Abhishek and I have been helping people use Linux for the past 12 years. And in this video, I'll share the steps that will enable you to turn the functional but boring default terminal in Ubuntu into this beauty. And all this will be done in a way that you can easily go back to the original terminal looks. Sounds good? Let's see. The entire procedure is composed of the following steps. I am using Ubuntu with the default GNOME terminal in this video. However, you should be able to replicate the steps on pretty much any other distribution and terminal. The installation command might be different for you if you are not using Ubuntu or Debian-based distribution. Just use your package manager and it should work for most of the packages mentioned here. In the later part of this video, I'll also share how you can get an even more beautiful looking terminal by using Kitty Terminal. Remember, you can do your own tweaking to the terminal, but the more closely you follow this tutorial, the more closer your terminal's final output will be to that of mine. And sit tight, as this will be a long ride, but worth every second of it. I advise watching this video at length first before you start following each step on your own system. I have also included all the necessary steps in the description. There are also a few config files specially created for this tutorial, and you can get them from our GitHub repository. Everything is in the description. Let the customization begin. First, you need good-looking Mono space font. I'm using JetBrains Mono. You can experiment with the fonts, but make sure that it is monospace. Otherwise, the letters will overlap in the display. Next, you need nerd fonts to display icons and emojis. I recommend these two nerd fonts. I have included all the download links in the description of this video. Once you have the fonts downloaded, you can either double-click on them to install, or you extract the downloaded files and copy all the fonts files in the .fonts directory under your home directory. I strongly recommend creating a new profile and doing all these customizations in this new profile. This way, you can easily revert to the default terminal looks by switching to the original profile. For that, go to the preference option and create a new profile. Name it whatever you want. But make sure that you have selected this newly created profile. Now go to the text tab. This is where we change settings like terminal size, font, cursor, etc. First, make the initial terminal size 120 columns and 25 rows. This will give us a slightly large terminal. Now, change the terminal font. Here, I'm using JetBrains Mono font. Change the font size to. Next, change the color settings of the terminal. In the Colors tab, disable the Use Colors from System Theme checkbox. And then select the Custom from the built-in schemes. Here, click on the color icon under Background. In the new color selection window, set the color to 2222222. Wow, 22, all the twos. I did that so the title bar of the terminal and the terminal background are of the same color. If the title bar of your terminal is of some other color, use a color picker tool to get the hex code and use the same for the terminal background. Next, I'm using ZSH. Also called G-cell or Z-cell. I call it ZSH. So, ZSH is a widely used POSIX compliant shell. Okay, maybe it's not as widely used and as widely popular as Bash, but it is still very popular. Also, it offers plenty of configuration via its robust plugin ecosystem. You'll need to install JetSH along with a few extensions that we will use later. I'll also recommend installing autocomplete plugin for a better experience when you actually work with the terminal. Unless you are using Arch Linux, you'll have to clone the Git repository and enter the clone directory. You will see this JetSH autocomplete plugin JetSH file here. We will need the path to this file in a moment. Now that you have these things installed, switch to JetSH and configure it. When you run Jet Shell for the first time, it will be quite plain and simple. Press 0 here to create an empty JetSHRC file and exit Jet Shell. Next, open the JetSHRC file for editing. You can use Nano or Vim or any other terminal-based editor of your choice. We need to source the plugins every time JetSH starts, so add these lines to this file here. Don't worry, you don't have to manually type it. I have the text in the description and you can copy it from there to paste it in the terminal, shift control V instead of control V and you'll be done. If you are using Nano, press Ctrl X to save the file and exit the editor. If you want to learn more about using JetSH, we have a good collection of resources on our other website, Linux Handbook. Do check it out. Starship is a fast, customizable terminal prompt. It works with any shell and it can be tweaked to look the way you want. There is an official script for installing Starship on any Linux distribution. Get the script using curl and run it like this to install it. Once Starship is installed, open your JetSHRC file and add this line before all those source lines. This is important. Let's quickly switch to JetSH and see how does it look now. Okay, it looks bad. I could have edited this part, but I wanted to show it to you. Earlier, I copied these lines to JetSHRC file. It seems the order is important here. Autocomplete plugin should come after auto suggestions and syntax highlighting. I have not investigated the root cause for this behavior yet. If you know it, enlighten the rest of us in the comments. Okay, when the changes are done, JetSH runs fine. But it still doesn't look as good as you would like it to be. Don't worry, we are getting there. But before that, let me thank the sponsor of this video.
ANY.RUN. ANY.RUN provides interactive malware analysis and threat intelligence services trusted by over 500,000 security professionals worldwide. With real-time interactivity, ANY.RUN's sandbox lets you safely analyze and engage with threats as if they were on your own computer. Plus, ANY.RUN's threat intelligence lookup helps you find specific threats and enrich existing indicators by searching a vast database.
So, even though it is not looking as good at the moment, let's make Jet Shell the default shell for the terminal profile. The terminal profile we created specifically for the customization. Copy the path to the executable of JetSH first. And then go to the terminal profile you have created for the customization and add it to the custom command field. Make sure to check the run custom command option. Let's take it to the next level and make this new profile the default profile for your terminal. This way, whenever you open the terminal with the selected profile, it will open the JetSH with all the fonts, colors, and the customization we did so far. Things are looking good. Let's make it look even better. Starship offers some cool prompt presets. You can find them on Starship website. You can browse through the provided screenshots, click on the preset you like, and it will take you to another page where you can see the command you need to use to enable it. Copy it and paste it in the customized terminal, and the prompt will be changed immediately. Do you notice what kind of information it shows in the prompt and the colors it has? Looks pretty, right? In fact, Srinath in its FOSS team has created a couple of Starship themes for you. They're pretty cool. Try them if you want. So basically, you have a dope looking terminal by now. The next few sections are optional. They are optional to add some more features and customization. If you want, you can stop right here. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't already and enjoy flaunting a pretty terminal. But if you stick with me a bit longer, you may discover some cool CLI tools like Atuin. You can use Atuin to get a better experience with your command history. Written in Rust, Atuin replaces your existing shell history with a SQLite database and records additional context for your commands. In simple words, when you press the up arrow to access history, you can get a new sleek look and more functionalities. You can even self-host Atuin on a server and sync your command history across systems if that's your thing. You can install it using the official script. And once installed, let me run a few commands so that it records them in the history. So now, if I press the up key, it brings up the history, which is scrollable and shows when the command was run and how long did it take to run it. You can inspect to see which directory the command was run into. You can refer to its documentation to utilize the full potential of this powerful tool. Okay, there are two reasons why I am installing Qt here. Second, the Fastfetch script that I'll show in the next section somehow needs a terminal like Qt or Qosty to be installed. The first reason, Qt itself is an awesome terminal. Okay, the bare Qt terminal may look plain, simple. So let's make all the changes we did for the GNOME terminal in Qt as well. Press Ctrl Shift plus F2 and it will open the Qt config in Vim. If you want, you can switch to Nano for the comfort. Everything has to be done in the terminal itself. No GUI here. So what you have to do is change the fonts, change the font size, make cursor trail 100, uncomment cursor trail decay and start threshold. Similarly, hide the window decoration, change the value to yes, and then also make some changes for the tab bar style and add the power line Starship prompt here. All these changes, all these things, I have mentioned it in the description. So just repeat what I did here. And as the final config change, search for shell, remove the dot and change the value to the JetSH location, which is user bin JetSH. Great. So save all the changes and see how the plain looking Qt transforms now. Does it not look pretty? Of course it does. The no window at the top gives it a minimalist look. And Qt is super fast. It feels snappy. I mean, you have to use it to feel it actually. We are almost at the end of this terminal customization process. To add some extra decoration, let's start Fastfetch each time the terminal starts. You'll have to install Fastfetch first. We have created a dope looking Fastfetch script for you. Get it from our GitHub repo. The README file has all the commands and steps in detail. Please follow it. I'm using this Fastfetch script here. Just copy the file to Fastfetch config and the JEDI image to the assets folder. Looks good, right? You can add the Fastfetch to ZSHRC file so that it runs Fastfetch automatically to display the system stats in a pretty format. And as you can see, with some effort, you have a beautiful looking but functional terminal at your disposal. In fact, if you follow this tutorial as it is, you will have two awesome looking terminals and you can use either of them. I'll let you enjoy this beautifully customized Linux terminal and flaunt it in your community. Keep on Linuxing and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.